Hello friends, press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon for more such easy videos.
Hello friends, I am back with a new video. In this video, I will be discussing about one of the most important topic, that is called as development of female gametophyte. Now when I use the word development of female gametophyte, it simply means one word, that is called as development of megaspore. And the process of development of megaspore is known as Megasporogenesis. Megaspore is female gametophyte and genesis is development. So logically, if I have to define Megasporogenesis, what I can say, it is the process of development of female gametophyte. Whenever we talk about female gametophyte, let's first understand that the female part of the flower is gynecium. Consists of three part, stigma, style and ovary, and inside the ovary there will be ovule, and that ovule is nothing but megaspore. So development starts from MMC. What is MMC? Megaspore mother cell. This MMC is formed from archisporial cell. Logically, when we talk about archisporial cell, we need to understand that this archisporial cell is hypodermal in origin. Hypodermal in origin means it has originated from the ovary walls. Now what we need to understand here, the next important part, that the primary archisporial cell is going to divide. Now this division will be periclinically. So we can say that the primary archisporial cell divides periclinically and it forms two cells, outer and inner cell. Outer cell is called as parietal cell and it can be also called as primary parietal cell, and the inner cell is called as primary sporogenous cell. What we need to understand here is that the primary parietal cell, it may or may not divide further, totally dependent on its nature. But the primary sporogenous cell will definitely not divide further and it is going to work as MMC. So the primary sporogenous cell is working as MMC. Now we need to understand here is that the MMC is diploid in nature. And what is the full form of MMC? It is megaspore mother cell. So this megaspore mother cell will first undergo meiosis, reductional division, and it produces four haploid megaspores. So these are called as linear tetrad. Now what we need to understand here is the upper three or the lower three cells, now they will degenerate. So MMC will give rise to haploid linear tetrad. Let us assume that the upper three cells have degenerated, and what will happen? It will give all its energy to the last megaspore left. So I put it in this way, upper three has degenerated, and finally what we get is the functional megaspore. So logically what we can say, this functional megaspore which is formed now is going to follow the next step of megasporogenesis. So this megaspore will be haploid in nature as it is produced from MMC by meiosis. Now what happens? This megaspore will undergo first mitosis. And since it undergoes first mitosis, it forms a two-celled stage. Because in mitosis, from one cell, you will always get two cell. So it is a two cell stage. Now, this two cell stage undergoes second mitosis and it forms four celled stage. Now, four cell stage we get here. So the two cells, they undergo mitosis. So two results in formation of four. So you can say it's a four cell stage. What is the next step? It will undergo third mitosis. So we can say that the four cell stage will undergo third mitosis, and we all know that four cell stage, when it undergoes third mitosis, it results in formation of eight cell stage, where four cells each are present at each pole. So now the most important step of megasporogenesis is going to take place. What will happen here? Since there are four cells at each poles, one cell from each pole, so we can say out of four cell, one cell from each pole will come or will migrate towards the center. And when they come in the center, what will happen? Only the cytoplasm will fuse, not the nucleus. This is the most important step that we need to understand with respect to angiosperm. This is not going to happen in gymnosperm. It will take place only in angiosperm. So what will happen now? So these three cells which are present now upward, they will develop into a specialized cell. I can say that they are antipodal cells. These antipodal cells are definitely haploid and they are towards the chalaza end. While towards the micropyle end, the middle cell is the egg cell. Surrounding the egg cell are the synergids. And what we need to understand, inside the synergid, you will see some finger-like projections that is called as filiform apparatus. In the center, the two cells only, the protoplasm, you can say the cytoplasm is going to fuse, but the nucleus will not be fused. It means the middle cell is a diploid cell, 2N, because it is having two nucleus. The antipodal cells will be haploid. The secondary nucleus will be diploid. Secondary nucleus is also called as definitive nucleus. The egg cell will be haploid. The synergids also will be haploid. So this is how you can understand megasporogenesis in a simplest way. Now we need to understand the synergids. They are having finger-like projections, that is called as filiform apparatus. So let's try to understand the entire structure of megasporogenesis, or the 7-celled and 8-nucleated megaspore. So what is going to happen here? So 7-celled and 8-nucleated structure that will be present in the embryo. So how the structure will look like? So we can say somewhere when you study the structure of ovule, inside the ovule you say nucellus, below that there is embryo sac, and inside the embryo sac what is present? 7-celled and 8-nucleated structure. So I am going to take the structure in detail. The three cells which are present towards the chalazal end, that is called as antipodal cells, and they are haploid. What is the role of antipodal cell? We can say the antipodal cells provide nourishment to the secondary nucleus. Secondary nucleus is the middle one with two nucleus and a single celled structure, and the secondary cell or secondary nucleus is diploid in nature. What is the role of secondary nucleus? It takes part in fertilization. The second fertilization takes place in the secondary nucleus. And towards the micropyle end, what we have? The middle cell is known as the egg cell, which is haploid in nature and will take part in fertilization that will form the embryo. Surrounding the egg cell, there will be the synergids, which is also haploid in nature, and inside the synergids there are finger-like projections called as filiform apparatus. The role of filiform apparatus is to attract the pollen tube for fertilization. The egg cell and the two synergids together, they are called as egg apparatus, and this entire setup is called as polygonum type. Now something very important we need to understand here. We told that out of four tetrad, you can say the upper three has degenerated. So we can say three megaspore degenerates and one forms the functional megaspore. Such type of ovule is called as monosporic ovule. But in some of the angiosperms, what happens? Instead of three, two megaspore degenerates and two becomes the functional one. So such type of ovules, they are called as bisporic ovule. In some of the angiosperm, one megaspore degenerates and three forms the functional megaspore, and that is called as trisporic ovule. And sometime in some of the angiosperms, what happens? None of the megaspore degenerates and four functional megaspores are formed. Such kind of ovule is called as tetrasporic ovule. Hope friends, you have understood the concept of megasporogenesis in a very simple way. If not, watch the video again, you will definitely understand. Till then, this is Sunil sir saying goodbye to you. Don't forget to like the video, and if you are new, do subscribe. Your like motivates me more to make such easy videos for you. Thank you very much.